everybody. It's good to be back with you once again. Today we're going to look at another of Christ's parables, the Pharisee and the Publican, and we're going to be in Luke chapter 18, verse 9 to 14. And we'll just look at how to be saved. But first of all, we'll just have a prayer to start with. So if you'd like to close your eyes and bow your heads, and we'll just have a prayer. Thank you. Dear Lord God and Father in heaven, we come to you, Lord, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we just pray that you would be with us, that you would bless us, Lord, during this time as we give the word of God to the children. I pray you help me, Lord, and I pray you help the children, Lord, that whoever listens in, Lord, that they would come to learn more of the things of God this day. And bless them, Lord, as they hear this parable and the teaching that is in it, Lord, about prayer. And I just pray for each child, Lord, listening in, that you bless each one, that you minister to their souls, Lord, that you pour your spirits out upon them, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that you just be with us. Bless us now, Lord, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, everybody. So, first of all, I think we will read the Word of God today because there's only a few verses. So, we're in Luke 18 and verse 9. And he spake this parable unto certain which trusted in themselves that they were righteous and despised others. Two men went up into the temple to pray, the one a Pharisee and the other a publican. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, God, I thank thee that I am not as other men are, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as this publican. I fast twice in the week, and I give tithes of all that I possess. And the publican, standing afar off, would not lift up so much as his eyes unto heaven, but smote upon his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his house justified, rather than the other. For every one that exalteth himself shall be abased, and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted. Okay, so we pray that the Lord will bless the reading of his word. So this parable was about two men who went to the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other was a publican. And Jesus was speaking to people who trusted in themselves that they were righteous, and yet they despised others. They looked down on other people. A Pharisee, we'll just look at what a Pharisee was first of all. A Pharisee, he was a religious man. He was very often found at the synagogue and in a prominent place. He followed every detail of the Jewish law. He wanted people to admire him and think that he had a devout life. And often he would pray at street corners so that people could see him. And he made sure everyone knew that he gave money to the temple. He dressed in a way that would mark him out as a religious leader, and he wore a part of God's law in a little box strapped to his forehead. He used to have it strapped here on his forehead and a strap around, and everybody could see that he had God's law strapped to his forehead. He dressed differently from other people, and in Matthew 23 verse 5, the description the Lord Jesus gave of the Pharisees was that all their works they did to be seen of men. So that's what the Lord said about them. They wanted to be seen of men. They wanted to be noticed. They wanted people to look up to them and think of them as holy. And it was not the hour of prayer when these two men went to the temple, but the Pharisee, he probably went because it was a public place and that he would be seen there going to pray. He was a proud man, and he was not humble at all. And then we look at the publican. The publican, he was a man who probably had not worshipped God for a long time. A publican back then in Jesus' day was a tax gatherer or a tax collector. He collected taxes. This did not make him popular with fellow Jews, but it made him rich. Most tax gatherers were cheats, and the people despised them. they did not like them. This man could take more money than the Romans' authorities required, and he could pocket the difference, keep the difference. And so he was cheating people out of money. He probably had done what he wanted and ignored the Lord until now. And then he went into the temple to pray. So we have both the Pharisee and the publican praying in the temple. Now, who do you think God listened to? The Pharisee or the publican? God does not listen to prayers because the person who prays occupies some special place or high place in society. God does not listen to prayers because somebody claims to be better than others. God does not listen to prayers just because someone is a president or a prime minister or holds some high up office. God is far more interested in the prayer itself and the attitude of the heart of the one who is praying. Jesus said in verse 11, "The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, 'God, I thank thee that I am not as other men are, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as this publican.' And in verse 12, 'I fast twice in the week, I give tithes of all that I possess.'" You see, the Pharisee was not really praying to God at all. If you look at his prayer, you'll see that he is actually not praying to God. He just proudly went through a list of all his imagined good deeds. And thank God, he was not sinful like other people. He was proud and taken up with himself. And whereas the publican, he was entirely different. He dared not look up. He turned his eyes to the ground. He beat his breast. And that is what people in that day did to show great feeling. They would beat their breast. And he cried out, "God, be merciful to me, a sinner." That's in verse 13. Now we can answer the question, which prayer did God answer? The Lord Jesus tells us he heard the second man's prayer, the publican. The publican came humbly to God. The Pharisee, he did not. The Pharisee was not really speaking to God. He was just telling himself how good he was. God does not listen to such prayers, for he sees inside the heart of such a person. Hearts like this are filled with pride, conceit, jealousy, and hatred. Note too, the Pharisee did not actually pray for anything. He didn't really ask for anything. When we pray, we need to ask the Lord, one, to forgive us for our sins. Two, to change us and make us one of his children. That is if we are not already converted. Three, to help us overcome the sins which grieve and hurt the Lord. We need to pray that God help us to overcome them. And four, to guide us and instruct us day by day. No one can have prayers answered who does not want pardon or forgiveness, a new life, or to be governed and ruled by the Lord. Notice too what the Pharisee did. He compared himself to the publican. He should have examined his heart in the light of the standards which God provides, not to a sinner. He said, "I am not as other men are, or even as this publican." You see, he was comparing himself to a sinner. The publican was a sinner. Now, God gives us his law, his commandments. They show us we are all sinners. We have all broken them. That is the standard the Pharisee should have compared himself to, the law of God. Then he would have realized he wasn't so good after all. But he looked down on the publican and thought, compared to him, he was really good. But the Lord Jesus knew his heart, and he wasn't as good as he thought. Jesus said the publican went to his house justified rather than the Pharisee. And then Jesus said, "For everyone that exalteth himself shall be abased, Now, here, he's talking about the Pharisee. He exalted himself. He lifted himself up. And he was brought down. He was humbled because God did not hear his prayer. And Jesus said, he that humbleth himself shall be exalted. And that was speaking of the publican. The publican humbled himself and he was lifted up. God heard his prayer. God answered his prayer. And his prayer found its way into the word of God. And today, we still read it. We still read this prayer today. God, be merciful to me, a sinner. We do not know what caused this tax gatherer to go to the temple. Maybe disaster had befallen him, or maybe he had grown tired of his evil life, or he had begun to think of death. We don't know. But we do know that as he entered God's house, he realized he had no right to speak to the holy God against whom he had sinned so much. He could only beg forgiveness. He was humble, he was sincere, he felt unworthy, he asked to be forgiven, he asked for mercy, and he went home justified, forgiven, and exalted. He was lifted up, he was promoted to being a child of God. What can we learn from this parable? One, no one is too bad or sinful to speak to God if they are truly repentant. Nobody is too bad to speak to God. No matter what you've done, you can always, always talk to the Lord about it. Number two, God will hear our prayers if they are genuine and heartfelt, and no matter how short or how simple they are. This was a very short prayer that the publican made. But it was genuine and heartfelt, and it was simple. And he was just honest with God, and God heard. And number three, we cannot fool God. We cannot pretend to be good and sinless. God sees right into our heart. And this was the Pharisee. He tried to be good and pretend to be good and sinless, and he tried to put over that he was this special person, but God knew his heart. And none of us can approach God or expect him to answer our prayers until we have first asked for mercy and forgiveness. That's number four. We need to ask God for forgiveness. Have you ever seen yourself as a sinner and humbly asked God's forgiveness? And if not, why not ask God today? Why not just come to the Lord and you can just ask God in the most simplest of words. Just ask God to save your soul. Ask him to forgive you for your sin. Ask him to have mercy upon you. Just as this publican did, he said, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. By saying he was a sinner, he was admitting his guilt, and he was asking God for mercy. And that's all you need to do. You just come to the Lord. Be saved. So we're going to have some questions now. I will ask the question and then I'll give you a few moments to answer. Have a little think about this and then I'll give you the answers. Describe a Pharisee. He trusted himself. He despised others. He followed Jewish law. He prayed on street corners, and he wanted to be seen of men, and he was proud. Describe a publican, or this publican. He probably had not worshipped God in a while, if he ever had. He was a tax gatherer, he was rich, and he could be deceitful with money. Did both men pray? Yes, they did. How did the Pharisee pray? He prayed with himself, and he listed all his imagined good deeds, and he prayed very proudly. He was proud. How did the publican pray? He had his eyes to the ground, he beat his breast, and he cried out to God for mercy. Which man had his prayers answered? The publican. When we pray, what should we ask God for? To forgive us our sins, to change us and make us one of his children, to help us overcome sin, and to guide us and direct us day by day. The Pharisee compared himself to the publican. Who or what should he have compared himself to? The law of God. What does the law of God teach us? The law teaches us that we are all sinners, because as we read the law of God, we realize we have all broken the law, all of us. Jesus said the publican went to his house justified. What had changed with him? What had changed when he went home rather than when he came into the temple? He was forgiven and he was made a child of God. Did God hear the publican's prayer? Yes, he did. Why? Why did God hear the publican's prayer? Because he came humbly to God. Will God hear our prayers? Yes, if we come humbly and ask for forgiveness and mercy, if our prayers are genuine and heartfelt, and if we trust in the Lord to save us from our sins. And so we're going to leave that there now for today, and we'll just have a short prayer just to close off. So if you would like to close your eyes again and bow your heads, and we'll just have a prayer. Thank you. Dear Lord God and Father in heaven, I thank you, Lord, that you do hear our prayers, and I just pray, Lord, that you would help us always to come humbly to you, Lord, that we would not be proud, Lord, that Lord, we would recognise that we are all sinners, Lord. We have sinful hearts. We all break the law of God, or have broken it, Lord. And Lord, I just pray that you would forgive us for our sins and wash us afresh in that precious blood of the Lamb. Pray for all the children, Lord, that you would help each one of them, Lord, to come to thee, Lord. And any, Lord, who are still unsaved, we pray, Lord, that they might hear the words of life and put their trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. And for those children, Lord, who are already saved, Lord, we pray that you would strengthen them in their faith, Lord, and lead and guide them, Lord. And so, Father, I pray for each child, Lord, and each family represented. I pray you be with them this week, Lord. Bless them, Lord. Keep them safe and keep them well. And bless them, Lord, as they break up from school on Friday, Lord, for the holidays. And keep them safe, Lord, until we meet again. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, so thank you very much, everybody, for listening in. And I hope you all have a good week and enjoy your holidays when you break up on Friday and have a bit of a break from school. I hope you have a nice time. And you've got some lovely weather today, and hope the weather's nice for you too. So have a good day, everyone, and thank you. Goodbye.